being slaves as a result of a 25-year war where over 2.5 million people lost their lives. People who are Christians, people who are Muslims, people who are Africans, people who had their own religions, who had lost their lives. I remember that first trip. I remember seeing a woman who had had her breasts burned off because she was suckling her child. I remember a young 16-year-old girl who was forced to have sex with her brother while they from the northern part of Sudan watched. And we had to interview her away from the tribe because she would have been ostracized by the people if they had known what had happened to her. I remember seeing two men who had tried to protect their families, who had their arms chopped off at the elbow, and their wives had to feed them. And their wives had to help them relieve themselves. That's what I remember on my first trip to South Sudan. No matter where we are, no matter who we are, whoever we are, wherever we go, we cannot forget the masses of women and children in South Sudan and Sudan. Whatever your role, and our diverse role, actors, media personalities, actors, politicians. We actually serve millions who will never be able to snag tickets to a fancy dinner. We serve the people of Sudan, the women taken from their families, their villages, children ripped from their mother's arms, sold into modern-day slavery. We are the servants, each and every one of them, to the voiceless, the powerless. And our devotion must be to those whom you have never met. So go forward. Speak truth to power. Demand justice for the people of Sudan. God bless you.